In this video, I will be reviewing a two-queen hive setup that I built using Apimaye Hives. I have an extra Apimaye that doesn't have any bees in it currently. I'm going to use that to break up the two-queen hive system back into two separate hives. First, let me explain the two-queen hive setup. I read an article that said you could create a two-queen setup by separating two colonies with a super full of honey, with a queen excluder above and below the honey super. In theory, the two excluders will keep the queens from fighting and killing each other. The bees from each colony can access the honey super by crawling through the excluder. The article stated that a two-queen hive, set up in such a manner, will produce more honey than the total honey produced if the two colonies were separated. I wanted to try this out myself. So I separated a strong colony into two separate brood boxes. I placed the brood box with the queen at the top position, followed by a queen excluder, then the honey super, another queen excluder, and then the lower brood chamber. In the lowest brood chamber, I placed open brood so that the bees could raise a new queen. This would give me two queens in one hive, separated by the queen excluders and honey super. One issue you may notice with the Apimaye hives is that the queen excluders tend to get propolized into the bottom of the boxes. This is easily solved by prying them out with a hive tool. Here I'm separating the excluder from the upper box. Unfortunately, when I inspected the lower brood chamber, I discovered that they did not successfully raise a new queen. So it seems that my experiment failed. So what happened? Why didn't my two-queen hive setup work? Let me know in the comments below, and if you enjoyed this content, please like and subscribe.